At long last, we have reached flowers, also called angiosperms. This largest and most diverse group of plants has about 300,000 species. Flowers appeared about 250 million years ago and have completely transformed our world. As we have just seen, until flowers appeared, all the pollination depended on wind. The evolution of flowers enabled plants to take advantage of animals to transfer pollen from plant to plant. We will discuss here the structure and function of flowers, both at the functional and at the morphological level. Functionally, each flower has three parts: advertisement, reward, and sex. The advertisement, the colors of the flower and its fragrance, are supposed to appeal to the vision and to the sense of smell of potential pollinators. I'm standing here in front of the amazing Wisteria at the entrance of the Safra campus of the Hebrew University of Jerusalem. It is easy to be impressed by this advertisement. Too bad that I'm unable to share with you the fragments of these flowers. In order to be effective in the long run, advertisement must be linked to some sort of reward. The first reward flowers offered their pollinators was pollen. While plants produce pollen in order to fertilize their ovules, pollen is also a highly nutritious protein, rich food for pollinators. Many plants produce large amounts of pollen. Most of it gets eaten by pollinators and only a small fraction fertilizes ovules. The second popular reward is nectar. This sugary solution is considerably cheaper for plants to produce and is much sought after by pollinators as a ready source of energy. There are other less common types of reward, like the provision of shelter. The third, and as far as the plant is concerned, the most important functional part of the flower are the sex organs, the male stamen and the female stigma, style and ovary, that generate the pollen and the ovules respectively. The aim of the plant is to cause pollinators to transfer pollen from its flowers to fertilize an ovule of another flower, preferably on a different plant, of the same species of course. These functional components are all based on the morphology of flowers, which we will address now.
The flower is composed of four structures, also called whorls, starting from outside: sepals, petals, stamen and carpel. The sepals, the outermost whorl, are typically green leaves that enclose the bud before the flower opens and protect its base afterwards. Some flowers lack sepals altogether. The petals are typically the largest and most colorful part of the flower and they serve for advertising it. Stamen are the male sex organs. They are composed of a stalk called a filament, topped by an anther, where pollen is produced by meiosis and from where it is eventually dispersed. The female sex organ, the pistil, is usually in the heart of the flower. It consists of the stigma, the style, and the ovary, where the eggs evolve. We will discuss fertilization in detail later in this chapter. Let us look at this Dreamia, a flower with a simple and classical structure. You can see here six petals, six stamen in the stigma, style and ovary in the middle. The huge diversity in flowers is all generated by varying the number, size, form and color of these structures. We see here photos of different flowers and can realize how these variations form an endless number of possibilities. In many cases, different structures fuse, for example, a tube that is formed from fused petals. Many flowers have a radial symmetry, and their petals are all of the same size and form. Other flowers have a bilateral symmetry, and their petals differ in size and form. Flowers are rarely solitary, and they usually bloom in great numbers. For example, this Judas tree, or this parasitic Kistanche, where only this lustrous inflorescence can be seen over ground. The more flowers an individual can produce, it will attract more pollinators on the expense of its competitors. Often, what we call a flower is an inflorescence composed of many flowers. The most prominent example are flowers of the Compositae family, which is, after the orchids, the second largest group of flowers. The inflorescence is composed of many small tube-like flowers, jam-packed in the middle and surrounded by flowers with one big petal. This gives these flowers their typical structure and enhances their advertising effect.